morning, everybody. It is our last day of exploring them. We are headed to Postojna cave and Predjama castle, and it's just about a 40-minute drive here from Ljubljana, and from there we'll head back to Zagreb. But we want to show you this beautiful cave here that's really not far away. It's very unique, and it has a train running all through the pathways and halls of the Postojna cave. So we're really excited to see that. I've never been before, and I think it looks incredible in photos, and I think these kids are gonna love it too. You guys excited to take the train through the cave?
Yeah. And I'm also gonna take a boat.
No boats today. No boats today. Okay, so we're here at the parking lot at Postojna Caves, and they said to arrive here about a half an hour early, so it's 11:30 now. We bought tickets for the 12 p.m. tour, so we're here really just on time. And I think just a portion of it is the train ride, and the rest is probably not on the train, but we're gonna find everything out right now.
Okay?
I'm ready.
Excited to go inside. It's a little bit drizzly rainy out here, so be nice and dry inside the cave, I think. Bit of a line to get in, but that's okay. See, it's quite a popular place even in the winter, so buy your tickets in advance. These trains are so long, I can't even believe it. They can fit so many people. Oh my goodness, look at this. Oh my gosh, hey guys.
Oh, it's cool.
Isn't it cool? Okay, so we are about to start our cool train ride through the cave. You want to take off your hood?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Okay. I'm not like this.
No, it's chilly in here. The temperature in here is a constant 8 to 10 degrees Celsius, and that's all year round. So be mindful of that if you come in the summer and you're wearing shorts and t-shirt outside. Make sure you have something warmer to wear inside the cave, because it is chilly in here. Postojna cave is also the only karst cave with the railway system. So this is really unique, and I think it's the most visited cave in Europe for sure. The track that we're going to go on is about 3.7 kilometers long, and it'll take us through all the hallways and corridors, and I think it'll be a really, really cool adventure.
It's really, really cool. Ooh.
And we're off, here we go, bye! So I guess that train will follow. It's quite rumbly in here, but it's really cool. Tell me, do you like it?
Yeah! Hiking up to the highest point inside the cave, and it's quite a hike. This cave is massive. It's honestly huge in here. If you look up, she said you can see a bunch of these tiny formations that look like spaghetti hanging from the ceiling. It's really an interesting sight. It's really cool. I don't know if you can catch all those fine details because it's kind of dark in here. You really, I think, have to see it in person. I know, you see the spaghettis, huh?
Yeah.
This cave was formed in two parts. The first part is much older, when the river was running through, and then it started forming the second part of the cave where we are now. And the river's still running through here, so it's still continuously forming the cave as the years go by. And everything is constantly changing and growing. The shape in the inside here is just in a constant slow change. I'm not really a cave person, but this is something you have to see if you're in the area. It's definitely worth checking out. This is like massive inside of here. She said it's 24 kilometers long, and through this tour we're gonna see 5 kilometers. So it started with a 2 kilometer train ride, and then we're walking, hiking through about a kilometer and a half, and then finishing off with another 2 kilometer train ride. So this thing is insanely big. Sophie, are you loving it?
Yeah.
Yeah, what do you like the best about it?
The cave.
You like the cave?
Yeah.
Why do you like the cave?
Because of the noodles.
Because the noodles? She does love pasta. This one looks like it's gonna meet. Not very soon, because it only grows at a rate of 1 centimeter per 100 years, but eventually that looks like it'll turn into a column. There we go. I wish it was brighter in here, but so I could show you the human fish, but they don't like light because they're used to living underwater in caves. They're nicknamed human fish because of their kind of fleshy skin, but they're completely aquatic, so they eat and sleep and breed underwater also. They have about 4 or 5 of them in this tank here that you can see, and we saw them, they're very snake-like. They're about 20 to 30 centimeters in length, and they have little tiny arms and legs that stick out. So here we're approaching this beautiful open hall area. And apparently they have concerts here sometimes. And the biggest concert they ever held here, they had 4,000 people inside the cave where I'm right now. Apparently the acoustics are amazing. And there's also a nice echo that bounces off. So I think it would be incredible to experience a concert here. Inside of a cave. The pathway goes right through the gift shop. How convenient. Okay, so that's like a human fish stuffed animal that Ollie has here. And that's a little dragon. They say actually that Postojna Caves was the home of the dragon, and a dragon lived here, and that these human fish were the dragon's offspring. With big rains, some of the water kind of brought these human fish to the surface, and people thought that these little human fish were the offspring of the dragon that lived in Postojna Cave. So that's a cool little story. Okay, so we just got back on the train now. It's kind of the end of the walking part of the tour, and now we're gonna go a little bit more, I think 2 more kilometers through the caves with the train. So there's the double track, so it can go both ways, which is very unique and the only cave in the world that has a double track, and that's pretty cool. It's such a unique system down here, just going through all the passageways to the different open kind of halls and just getting to see all of this whole tunnel system.
Yeah, I expected that it would be slower, but that's actually fast.
Yeah. Yeah, I also thought it was going to be a bit of a slower train, kind of just easily taking us through with some audio guide or something. But it's a nice train ride that really brings you through. You cover a lot of ground since it goes pretty quick. And then you really get to walk through, take your time, see some beautiful sights inside here, and then a quick train ride again. To think about. Okay, we are officially out of Postojna Cave now. It is a little bit drizzly, gloomy, and now we're gonna go check out Predjama. But before we do the castle, I think that we need a snack. What do you guys think?
Yeah.
Yeah? We just opened the trunk and I realized that we have some domachitsa in the back, so that'll be a little snack for now. Who wants some domachitsa?
I. Who wants keksi? Come with me.
Oh, hello there, my lady.
Oh, beautiful. So here you can see that it's built right into this rock face. The castle dates back to the 12th century, but much of what you see now is from the 16th century. It's actually the biggest cave castle in the world, and it has a really cool legend that goes with it. In the 15th century, there was someone named Erasm Predjamski, and he was kind of like a Slovenian Robin Hood. He used to steal from the rich and give to the poor. And at one point, his enemies surrounded him and wanted to capture him. And so they surrounded the castle here. But what they didn't know was the castle was over top of like this cave and tunnel system. And so they were trying to starve him to force him to come out or force him to surrender, but they didn't know he had access to food on the other side in the valley, so he was totally fine. And I guess in the springtime, when the cherries weren't yet ripe on this side of the mountain, he went to the other side and picked some very ripe cherries and sent them out to the enemies to kind of trick them. So they didn't know how he had these beautiful ripe cherries, that they thought it was magic. But unfortunately, after a year of being under siege, one of his servants betrayed him, and that was the end of the siege. So they got him, unfortunately. But the whole story around this castle, the legend around this castle, is very, very interesting. So we're gonna go inside now to take a deeper look into this beautiful Predjama castle. Voila. It just seems really impressive that they built this castle on this rock, 123 meters off the ground, and that they were able to do that with everything they had back in the 12th century. So in here, I guess, is where they would hold the prisoners. It's like a prisoner chamber in here. Do you guys like having those audio guys?
Yeah. They're like telling a lot about this castle.
Are you listening to each number?
Yeah.
Awesome. What language is the program for you? English or Croatian?
For me, it's English.
Creation.
Oh, this is a toilet in here, guys.
Maybe they killed him.
Is this
him
where
here.
They got him?
Yeah, maybe.
You guys, how would you like this as a toilet, huh?
Is that a toilet?
It's a toilet, yeah.
Mine's not.
Basically, they're saying about the toilet, how it was just a hole in the wall and it was going down, like, you know, the gravity would do it.
Do its trick.
Not, they didn't have a toilet paper, they were using a cabbage leaf. Cabbage leaf to wipe their butts instead of toilet paper.
Here is, in this hallway here, you can't even really tell where the rock face ends and the structure of the castle begins. It's kind of all blended into each other, and it's amazing how they were able to make that.
Oh, look at that. They were like washing their dishes here.
And look at this, water would just go down. Oh my gosh. No plumbing systems back in 54. This castle back in the day. I didn't expect our kids to be so into it. They were kind of getting tired. I didn't really know how much we'd be able to do with the castle. But they just want to keep going. They love the audio guide. It's really getting them going, huh? What's up there?
I don't know.
Is that the secret tunnel up there?
Yeah. Like the telephone said, a secret tunnel.
This is the tunnel which the river was going on the other part of the valley, where he was getting food and the cherries for his enemies.
Wow, look at how spectacular this looks. Oh, cool. Is this not so cool? Gosh, I didn't expect it to open up into the cave like this. So this cave part was inside the castle, so that I guess if anyone ever got into the castle, this would be like their last escape. Here they have that wooden bridge that separates this part of the castle from the cave part of the castle. So if anyone ever came into the castle and got through, they could always escape to the cave part, drop the bridge, close everything, and they could have like a last chance at escaping into the cave and then out on the other side. So this would be kind of a a last effort to escape enemies. Here would be their water source. They'd collect water from this constant drip into this barrel, and that would be their drinking water. Every little turn of this castle, and there's so many little interesting pieces of information. What was your favorite part of the castle, Ollie?
Mine was when they were hanging up the bad thieves.
The prisoners.
Yeah.
Like pulling them, like they're like
legs
and arms. That was painful. It's
like, Matthew, what about you?
The toilet.
The toilet was your favorite part? It was kind of crazy, huh?
Oh, they were pooping there, huh?
I definitely suggest to visit this castle if you visit the Postojna cave.
Yeah. It's not far away, it's only like 10-minute drive, and the ticket's included. If you buy a ticket for Postojna, it's included.
Package.
Yeah, you can get a package.
And what they saved.
What? Oh, you saved a cookie. Okay.
In my pocket.
Oh, the whole time, huh? Mm-hmm. Oh.